Coming up, new tools for managing servers across versions of Windows and Linux and across cloud platforms. We'll show you the updates to Project Honolulu, allowing you to manage Windows Server configurations from one place, and how we're moving from Windows PowerShell to PowerShell Core, letting you manage your servers wherever they are from just about any device and across Linux and Windows. So I'm joined again by Jeff Woolsey from the Windows Server team. Welcome.
It's great to be back.
So we've been evolving the tools to manage servers to become more flexible. And last time we saw an early look at Project Honolulu to configure and manage Windows servers.
That's right. We know that most of you have infrastructure that runs multiple versions of Windows Server or other server platforms. For example, you have Windows Server running on physical or virtual machines. These workloads might be located in your data center or hosted in a cloud service like Azure or AWS. You probably want to manage your infrastructure either using a graphical user interface, a GUI, or a command line via the browser from a PC, Mac, or other device. So whether you're using a command line or a GUI on whatever device you're using, we want to provide a great experience.
So what has the team done to deliver against that?
The last time I was on the show, we talked about Windows Server version 1709. We also discussed some of the challenges with the multitude of tools that you typically have to use to manage Windows. So we're moving to a unified management hub. And let me switch on over to Project Honolulu. Now, what this allows you to do is gives you the ability to monitor and troubleshoot your Windows through this Honolulu portal. So let me walk you through it. And by the way, if you've already started evaluating Honolulu, I'll point out some of the updates along the way. So the first thing I want to show you here is I'm at the Honolulu start page here at the server manager, and I'm going to add some server connections. Now I can come in here and I can simply type in some of the names of these, but I'm going to go into import servers, where in fact I've created a text file with a whole bunch of names of servers that I've already have running, and I'm going to simply submit those. And in fact, these are the servers that I'm going to manage. You can see here that I've got four silver nodes here. These are my physical servers. These green and red nodes are actually my Windows servers running in virtual machines. So let's go ahead and click on silver node one, and I'm connecting to it. I want to point out that everything I'm running right here is actually happening here on my Surface Pro. You can see here on the overview page, you see most of the things you would expect to see typically in Task Manager. For example, I can see CPU, memory, Ethernet, additional things like that. I can see the computer name, the domain, and in fact, if I want to change that, I can do all of that remotely by changing the name of the computer or joining a work group or changing domains. Also, I'm going to point out devices. Now, typically using the traditional RSAT tools, I'd have to leave the task manager and go to something like device manager. Well, here in Project Honolulu, I can see, for example, my devices like my network adapter. I can click on my network adapter. I can actually see here's the driver and here are the details behind that driver as well. Another thing I commonly want to do is I want to take a look at events on my server. So for example, here I'm going to go to my event tool. And you can see here under Windows logs, I'm going to take a look at some of my security logs. Now you notice, wow, I actually have quite a few of these. I'm going to take a look at these. So the first thing I want to do is I want to go here and filter this out. And we can easily filter these out to show you just the critical errors. So I don't want to see any of the warning or any of the verbose things. And if you used earlier versions of the technical preview, you probably noticed that was a lot faster. We've done a whole bunch of performance work under the hood to make the Honolulu even faster. Next, let's quickly move on over to files. Last thing I want to show you, of course, is that I can, of course, create files. I can manage files all remotely using Honolulu. For example, if I need to create a new folder, simply create a new folder. Let's call this a temp folder. Quickly click on submit. And just like that, there's my new temp folder. So I can copy files to it. I can delete files, things you would normally expect. Now, one of the most requested features, and I want to take a moment to say thank you to our folks on Windows Server User Voice, is that we've actually had folks providing us feedback and input for the things that they really wanted to see in Project Honolulu. And one of those things is remote desktop.
And remote desktop is definitely a tool that any Windows Server admin is going to want.
Yes. Now here we are using RDP over HTML5, and I'm in a server core, and you can see, this is great, I'm running headless, exactly the way you want to manage a server.
That is awesome.
So I'm able to log in, and you can see this is simply just server core. Now, one of the other top requested features I want to show you, of course, is PowerShell. So one of the things people tell us they want to do is, you know, I get that Honolulu is great for doing a lot of the common things, but what if I need to get under the hood, for example, and I want to be able to bring up a full command line of PowerShell? Well, you can see I brought up a PowerShell. I've typed in get VM, and I get some statistics on some of the VMs here. And by the way, I should also point out that, yeah, you have full IntelliSense as well. So these were both highly requested features from user voice. So we can now even remote into client PCs. This is also a brand new feature in Honolulu. Yes. I'll head up here. Instead of server manager, you can see we have computer management. And in fact, I'm going to go here. And just like I did before, I could simply add a computer by typing in the name. Or in this case, I'm also going to go ahead and import a client name to import as well. And in fact, here's a client system I can manage as well. And I can click on it. I can connect to it, and you can see I still have a rich set of features. I can see an overview of the system, certificates, devices, events, firewall configuration, mm-hmm. and so much more.
And you made it look easy.
Yes.
And it's great to see RDP support on the new PowerShell integration in Honolulu, and it opens up a lot more management capability beyond just the common user interfaces. And better still, it looks a lot faster than last time.
Yes. So we saw PowerShell in Honolulu performing commands against Windows machines. And when we think cross-platform, the new PowerShell Core really delivers against the promise of managing any server from just about any device. So a few months back, we announced PowerShell support for Linux, and now PowerShell version 6 is generally available for common distros. Ubuntu, Debian, Red Hat, OpenSUSE, Fedora, and even beyond Linux, we can run it on macOS. We even have a Docker container packaged up with PowerShell Core.
Cool.
You can get to all of these packages on GitHub, as well as community-supported packages. In fact, over 50% of the updates and changes in PowerShell V6 came from the community.
Awesome stuff. And PowerShell, just like Honolulu, can be used remotely. So as long as I have network access, I'm good to go. So on-premises and in Azure?
That's right. In both cases, the tools just need to be able to broker a connection to the resource, and the server can be in the cloud or in your data center. Now, for resources in Azure, you can even use Cloud Shell with PowerShell to manage resources right from your browser.
Ooh, can we take a look?
Absolutely. On this system, I've enabled the OpenSSH preview, and we've installed PowerShell Core 6. In Visual Studio Code, you can toggle the version of PowerShell in the lower right-hand corner to use PowerShell 6. Now, we can now SSH into Windows or Linux environments. Now, here I am in VS Code, so I'm going to start a session against a Windows and a Linux session. You can see their IP addresses here. And in fact, I'm going to run this invoke command against both machines. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select these three lines, and I'm going to click Run Selection or click F8. Now, I'm prompted for passwords here, and I'm going to type in the password for my Linux system and now for my Windows system. And now, once I've logged into these both, I can run the invoke command. And what I'm going to do is I want to highlight the fact that I'm running both of these processes, these mixed processes, and I can actually get a listing of both of these simultaneously. So I'm going to now run these mixed processes. And I'm going to run the selection again. And in fact, you're seeing a complete list of all of the processes interspersed between, again, both Windows and Linux systems simultaneously in the same view. Now let's do the same thing. And this time I'm going to filter it so that I see, for example, just the mixed processes starting with the letter S. So again, I'm going to select this. I'm going to highlight, right click, go to Run Selection or F8. And now you can see I have just a listing of all of the processes that start with the letter S. So think about what you're seeing here. We have a unified connection into Windows and Linux. We ran the same PowerShell commandlets to both platforms, and the result was the output from both Windows and Linux in one unified console. So we can now use SSH now for Linux and Windows platform, allowing true cross-platform PowerShell remoting. And the great thing is that I don't need the complexity to switch contexts. And if I'm already proficient in PowerShell with Windows, I'm basically ready to start managing Linux as well. So now, if I close that connection and remote into a Windows machine, I can run the same commandlet and use the same syntax there as well via SSH.
Now, this is phenomenal, especially for heterogeneous environments. And we're seeing the ability to easily manage from different sources and targets with command lines and GUIs. But going back to Honolulu for a minute, in the past, we used things like the remote server admin tools, or RSAT, that tightly coupled the Windows client and the Windows server version. Is this still the case?
No, Honolulu is much more flexible, providing you the ability to install on Windows 10 or onto a jump box. So you can manage Windows Server 2016 all the way back to Windows Server 2012 with a browser.
Awesome. Now, earlier you mentioned that Honolulu is extensible. So does that mean we can see more things coming?
Yes. Honolulu was built with extensibility at its core. Each of the tools you see are actually plugins to Honolulu. And right now, we're currently working with our partners on a private preview of the Honolulu SDK, and we're working to deliver a public preview of the SDK soon. For example, we have some hardware partners that are working with us around plugins for special hardware, like support for things like BMCs and more.
Awesome, that'll be cool. So lots of great updates and more on the way. Now, if you want to get started with Honolulu and PowerShell Core, where should I get started?
Well, you can download the installer for Project Honolulu at the link shown. And keep checking back to Windows Server Insiders for updates to when the Honolulu SDK preview releases. If you want to access PowerShell Core, you can grab the installers from GitHub at the link shown.
Awesome, thanks, Jeff. These tools are definitely going to come in handy for most sysadmins out there, which is great. And that's all the time we have for this show. But of course, keep checking back to Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. See you soon.